Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this video I will cover ISRO Technical Assistant Mahendra Giri 2016 paper I will cover. This is last part. Question is, resistance of a material to fatigue is indicated by, fatigue means endurance limit it will come, so C is your correct answer. Then line balancing is imperative in dash production. It's in mass production. B is your correct answer. Question is, fuel cells runs on. D is your correct answer. Hydrogen is your correct answer. Then 1 HP or 1 horsepower equal to dash kilowatt. It's 0.735 kilowatt. 0.735. C is your correct answer. Your next question. Dash maintenance requires monitoring plant equipment health. Preventive maintenance, no. Scheduled maintenance. Predictive maintenance requires monitoring plant equipment health. C is your correct answer. Which one is your attribute control chart? Control chart, two types. Variable type and your attribute chart. Variable type and attribute type. In attribute type, you will get P chart and C chart. Variable, X chart, R chart. And C chart, it's Poisson distribution, and P chart is your binomial distribution. Both are important. Binomial distribution. Then variable chart, these are your continuous data. This year, ISRO scientist exam, they ask this question. Attribute, this is your discontinuous data. So here, attribute control chart, P, B is your correct answer. They may ask this one also, variable control chart examples. This is very, very important. Control charts is very, very important for all exams. Even if GATE also they are asking. GATE, IAS, ISRO scientist. Other PSU exam also they are asking. Control chart examples. This is also important question. A circle will appear in an isometric drawing as. D is your correct answer, ellipse. In isometric drawing, it will appear as ellipse. ABC analysis or always bilateral control analysis is a tool for dash management. It's good for inventory management. And we know from ABC analysis, in 2016, one more exam was there conducted by Mahendra Giri. That exam also they asked one question from ABC analysis. So ABC analysis also important. A type material, B type material and C type material. A type material is costly. B type material is medium costly. C type material is less costly. But C type high value of high uses and B type medium uses, A type less uses. So here ABC analysis is a tool for inventory management. Thermal stress in a material proportional to alpha delta T E, thermal stress, or temperature stress equal to alpha delta T E. So here First one is elastic modulus E. Yes, this is correct. Thermal stress is proportional to E, then thermal stress is proportional to coefficient of expansion alpha. This is also correct, directly proportional. Then temperature difference delta T, this is also correct. Temperature stress or thermal stress is proportional to all three. So, D is your correct answer. Question is, the behavior of mild steel or MS under creep is a result of under creep. Is a result of strain hardening, yes. Then annealing, this is also correct. So both A and B. C is your best option. Helical spring formula is very very important. This formula K equal to 64 RQN divided by, formula is K equal to, K is your stiffness, G D to the power 4 divided by 64 RQN. This is your formula, and we know K into delta, stiffness into deflection is delta, it's equal to load W. So here, in this question, an helical spring of coil diameter or capital D is 50. This is capital D and is subjected to axial load W. Another spring has coil diameter 25 mm but otherwise identical to the first. The deflection of second spring will be how much? So delta 1 in case of second spring we have to calculate. So K delta equal to W by K. W by K you will get W into 64 RQ. R is your mean, your coil radius, and small d is your wire diameter, spring wire diameter. So here both are identical, so W is same. Only coil diameter is changing. Coil diameter means or coil radius. Capital R is changing. Number of turns N is same. D also small d. Wire diameter is small. Same. And G also modulus of rigidity. G also same. So delta is proportional to RQ. Coil radius. Then delta 1 by R1Q equal to delta 2 by R2Q. The deflection of second spring relation we have to calculate. Delta 2 by delta 1. It's equal to R2 by R1Q. R2 is 25 divided by 2. It's 12.5. R1 is 50 by 2. 25 it's Q. So it's 1 by 8 or delta 2 equal to delta 1 by 8. This is your answer. C is your correct answer. This formula is very very important. K equal to G D to the power 4 divided by 64 RQN. And this one K delta equal to W. This two is very very important for all exams. So this is end of Mahendragiri paper, 2016 paper. Thank you friends. Thank you for watching my video. Thank you.